three, two, one, in action. What is up, Travels with Buddy Nation? We're on the Travels with Buddy Station. Today is Monday, July the 18th. And another warm, well, actually today was a warm day, and we got a lot of rain today, huh, bud? We got some torrential rain, so we didn't go out for a walk today. But we're gonna work out in the house, right, bud? And tomorrow is supposed to be like in the 90s and sunny, so I don't know if I'm gonna take Bud out for a walk. I'll probably take him out in the backyard, because it'll probably be too hot for him to go outside. Anyway. But he's chilling. Bud's doing good. He's chilling. And I take him for rides and stuff, but it gets a little too hot, though, for him to go for walks. Not Bud. For long walks, anyway. But anyways, for today's workout, I'm gonna do a dumbbell deadlift, like a regular deadlift. Deadlifts is a really good exercise. But I'm gonna do the deadlift. I'm gonna do the deadlift with the dumbbell, and I'm gonna do it very light. I'm gonna do about maybe 10 to 15 reps. When I do deadlifts, I try not to do more than 15 reps. Even if I feel like I can do more, I try to stop at 15, because the deadlift is a really good exercise. It works a lot of muscles. It works your quads. It works your hamstrings. It works your glutes. It works your lower back, and it works a lot of your core muscles. It's a really good exercise to do. And basically, I'm gonna warm up with 220-pound dumbbells, which is very light for a dumbbell deadlift. But basically, I'm gonna just be working on my form doing the deadlift, and it's a really good stretch for your back, your hamstrings. Quads, it works the quads. And basically, I'm just gonna do the exercise very, very lightly. A lot of people, when they do deadlifts, they overdo it. They end up, they try to use too much weight, and then they end up hurting their backs, and hurting their knees, or pulling muscles. It's a good exercise. You can go very heavy, but it's also an exercise that you wanna warm up thoroughly before you put a lot of weight on the deadlift. You can do the deadlift with the barbell, you can do it with the dumbbell. When I go heavy, like after I warm up, I prefer using a bar. I know I did a video of me doing barbell deadlifts probably a couple of years ago. If you're following this channel, you can check it out. You can scroll down and check out my barbell deadlifts. And I think I did about 10 reps with, I forgot how much weight it was. But deadlift is also a good exercise for toning, you know, for just toning and strengthening your muscles, not so much for building mass and putting on, you know, a lot of muscle mass and weight and everything, which a lot of people use a deadlift for. But you don't necessarily have to use a deadlift for powerlifting. You see a lot of powerlifters use the deadlift, but it's also a really good exercise, like I say, just for toning your core muscles in your body. And you don't necessarily need to go very heavy. As a matter of fact, especially when you're warming up, you shouldn't go heavy at all. So without further ado, I will demonstrate the deadlift. I'm gonna use dumbbells to do the deadlift. And Bud, you can spot me from the other room. And later, we'll go outside. I'll take him backyard for a little bit so he can do his business, and I'll make him some supper. Okay, bud? And Buddy's just chilling. Okay, bud? Buddy looks very relaxed today. I took him out for a ride yesterday. He liked that. He liked going in the car and going for a ride. And today he's had a chilling, relaxed day. I'd like for you to face the camera though, so we can see you in the camera, so your fans can see you. Yeah. And Bud's looking awesome. It's it's getting close to supper time. Usually I work out a little bit earlier than this, but today I had a busy day, so I'm working out a little bit later in the evening. And so I could tell Buddy he's a little tired. It's probably a little past his bedtime right now, so he's just chilling. So I'll probably put him in the other room, and he could take a little nap. He can take a nap in the other room while I'm training, because it is late for him, right, Bud? It's past his bedtime, and he's got his little spot over here in the living room where he likes to watch TV and just chill out, right, Bud? And later I'll make you a snack, and then we'll go to bed. All right, so I'm gonna put Bud in the other room, and I will demonstrate the deadlifts. And today it is muggy out there. I got the air conditioners on, and because all the rain that we got, it made it kind of muggy. All right, in fact, I'm gonna throw on my belt. A lot of people, when they do the deadlift, they let their egos get in front of them, and they tend to use too much weight. And it is an exercise where you can go pretty heavy on it, but it's also an exercise that you should also warm up lightly and practice your form and doing the exercise properly before you start going really heavy. Okay. So basically, I'm just warming up with a couple of light dumbbells, and I'll try to go for about 10 to 15 repetitions. Basically, it's a very simple exercise, but it's very effective. It's a very good exercise to do. You want to stand, put your feet about shoulder width apart, and you're gonna, when you bend forward, you want to bend your legs, and just bring the weight down towards your ankle. Count along with them. And when you come up, you want to use your legs to bring your body up. Right, I got 15 repetitions, and I'll tell you, I could have went a lot heavier, but I felt a really good burn. Like I say, my quads, my hamstrings, my glutes, and the muscles in my lower back, I felt them working just hard enough for them to work and not to overwork, especially your lower back. You don't want to work the muscles in your lower back so hard that you pull them. Basically, it's a really good basic exercise for working your core. And like I say, a lot of people, when they do this exercise, they tend to go too heavy. And that's a mistake a lot of lifters make when they do this exercise, because they let their egos get in the way of doing the exercise properly. Like I say, again, it is a good exercise to go heavy on. Like I'll use, like when after I'm done warming up, I'll put my 25-pound plates on the dumbbell, and I'll probably go 60, 70 pounds, 80 pounds for each dumbbell to do the exercise, and I'll get about 5 reps with it or whatever after I'm thoroughly warmed up. But my main thing when doing this exercise is proper form and warming up. So you want to use proper form and warm up when you're doing this exercise. And again, it's a great core body exercise, whether you're a power lifter, a regular weight lifter, if you're just somebody that just wants to tone and strengthen your core, your midsection, your legs. And it's a good exercise for that. Now, I'll do this exercise again, and I'll do the exercise from the side. That way there you can see what this exercise looks like from like a side view. That's from the front. I don't know if it's how well you can see how I do the exercise. I might get a better view of the exercise if I do it from the side. It's a very simple exercise. You just lean forward, bend at the hips and knees, and just bring the weight down as far as you can comfortably go. I'll try to do about 10 more reps or so. You want your feet about shoulder width apart. Just like if you were doing a barbell squat. I got 12 reps. And this is an exercise you really don't need to get a lot of reps with. I feel more comfortable going heavy, even if I'm using low intensity and I use low reps, because you're working a lot of muscles. I think it's a great exercise to do. It's a deadlift with dumbbells. You can do this exercise with a bar, but remember, it's a great exercise to do, which you always want to warm up light and always watch your form when you're doing this exercise. And remember, if you like these videos, make sure you subscribe to Travels with Buddy. Have an awesome day. Keep training, keep lifting, and also remember to keep taking those walks. All right, everybody. Peace out.